Why learning malware analysis is so difficult? I see this frustration in so many people when they are starting to learn malware analysis. And then partly, there are two reasons for that. The first reason is this. People start to learn from so many different resources, especially resources that are not really used to teach, YouTube videos and some different articles here and there. And the problem is that what I see in lots of YouTube videos especially, is that these videos, they don't teach you how they reach that point of understanding. They just show you how this malware could be analyzed. You click three clicks here, you look here, you see that, you see this comment means this and this and that, and they give you the answer this way. Unfortunately, it doesn't tell you how he thought about this answer, how he discovered in the first place, what he used Google for, and how he got this information. The truth is that when we do an analysis for a malware, we don't just click five times, if eight, and we reach a specific point or a specific number, we magically know that this is the time to start doing 1, 2, 3, 4, and voila, the malware is unpacked or the protector has been bypassed. The truth is, it's not like that. We get into fail many times, and you need to see that to be able to understand how malware unstuck and how he unstuck himself when he gets stuck. How he even used Google and what comments he doesn't know, and how he actually get to outsource from outside to learn about different commands and different techniques and different things. Because once you understand how he does his research, you'll be able to do that research yourself when you're analyzing a malware. Unfortunately, lots of YouTube videos, yes, they are not really good for teaching. And you need to find and you need to be very, very selective on your resources when you're learning malware analysis. The second reason is that lots of resources that teach malware analysis out there, assuming that the people are actually computer science graduates who are actually worked as developers or in some different companies. But the truth is that most of the people who are learning malware analysis, especially these days, are from different backgrounds. They are from administration background or cybersecurity background, like a SOC analyst or network security, and they want to shift their career into malware analysis. And their backgrounds, the same like me, they are not coming from computer science background or from development background, from programming background. And that's why defining the resources very difficult. Unfortunately, that's a common thing in the market, that most of the resources are more for programmers. And that's why you need to understand first, what are your skills? What are your capabilities? And what resources that suit you the best? So again, you need to be very, very selective on the resources you're learning from. You need to see what are the languages they are using and what the prerequisites that they assume that the student actually have or has before he start learning or start reading that book or start consuming this information. So malware analysis is not very difficult if you have the right resources to learn. I just wanted to mention at the end of this video that, which we are at the end now, that I have actually a malware analysis training that's created mainly for the people who are from administration background. Either they are IT admins or SOC analysts, or people who are actually students even, not in computer science, people who don't have this programming background and they don't have these prerequisites that's required in every single book or training out there. I help these people learn malware analysis. I practically, actually, we do analyze malware together. And when I do the malware analysis with them, I actually show them how exactly I think. It's a, like, it's a recorded video, the training, and I show you exactly how I think in every single step. I don't just get the answer, assuming the answer. Some of the videos actually recorded that I see this malware for the first time and I do the analysis on that malware for the first time. And I start to think, okay, I don't know this information. I start to search for it. And I also show you that I know what level you are at that before watching this video, and I know what commands you know and what you don't know and how you can research to know more and to be able to analyze malware that has new commands or new stuff that you haven't seen before. So I will put the link of this video around here. It's maltrack.com/join/go. And I hope to see you there. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.